Hey everyone, in this video, I'm going to be going through a sketch to explain used cars, an acronym explaining causes of non-elevated anion gap metabolic acidosis. I've done a similar video before explaining MUDPILES, which covers causes of elevated anion gap metabolic acidosis. If you haven't seen it, make sure to check it out. It will be linked in the description below. But without further ado, let's get into this sketch titled Cal's Junkyard Water Park. First, notice that this scene is taking place right next to the sea. Since the park is at sea level, this should help you remember that used cars describes causes of non-elevated anion gap metabolic acidosis. The junkyard containing a bunch of used cars is owned by a man named Cal. He made so much money from the junkyard that he decided to build a water park right next to it. Who knew that owning a junkyard could be so profitable? He's quite the entrepreneur. His name is Cal because non-elevated anion gap metabolic acidosis is sometimes referred to as hyperchloremic metabolic acidosis, since a rise in chloride offsets the loss in bicarbonate, resulting in a non-elevated anion gap. Cal for chloride. The first letter, U, of our mnemonic stands for uteroenterostomy, which is a connection made between the ureters and the colon. In particular, uterosigmoidostomies can be a risk factor. The urine contains lots of chloride, and when it is diverted to the sigmoid colon, chloride is exchanged for bicarb, and bicarb gets wasted in the stool. Notice that this water slide looks suspiciously like the colon, and we have the ureters from the kidneys being diverted to it, representing a uterosigmoidostomy. S stands for saline administration. Excessive chloride intake through saline causes a rise in plasma chloride and kidney bicarb elimination, precipitating metabolic acidosis. We will conveniently represent saline by the C. The E in used cars stands for endocrine disorders, in particular, adrenal insufficiency, sometimes called Addison's disease. When the adrenal cortex doesn't produce aldosterone, H+ doesn't get excreted, which can cause acidosis. We'll represent the adrenal insufficiency by damaged adrenal glands atop the kidneys, and one of them falling over. D stands for diarrhea. This is probably the most important one to remember because it is the number one cause of non-elevated anion gap metabolic acidosis. To represent this, we have poopy diarrhea water flowing out of the slides into the pool. We even have it coming out of the colon slide to really hammer in that this is diarrhea. Next up, the mnemonic is C, which stands for carbonic anhydrase inhibitors. Probably the most well-known drug of this class is acetazolamide. Carbonic anhydrase facilitates reabsorption of bicarb in the kidney, converting the polar H2CO3 into absorbable H2O and CO2, and then this enzyme helps reform bicarb inside the cell. Inhibiting this enzyme causes loss of bicarb in the urine and creates risk for acidosis. Acetazolamide used to be used as a diuretic, but not so much anymore. Nowadays, it's mainly used to treat glaucoma, idiopathic intracranial hypertension, and mountain sickness. We're going to hone in on the glaucoma treatment by placing eyeballs in the headlights of the cars, reminding you of acetazolamide and carbonic anhydrase inhibitors. A is for ammonium chloride, a rarely used drug given as treatment in severe cases of metabolic alkalosis. It increases H+ concentration in the blood, and the chloride offsets the anion gap. Notice that this man in the corner is cooling off in front of an AC machine, AC for ammonium chloride. He's also relaxing with a cool glass of milk. This is to remind you that ammonium chloride is given to treat severe metabolic alkalosis. The R in used cars stands for renal tubular acidosis. There are several types of this condition. In type 1, there is an inability to excrete H+ in the distal convoluted tubule. In type 2, there is impaired bicarb reabsorption in the proximal convoluted tubule. And in type 4, there is low aldosterone, which impairs H+ secretion in the distal convoluted tubule. In all cases, there is risk for metabolic acidosis. We'll represent RTA by someone relaxing with an inner tube in the diarrhea pool. Last but not least, S is for spironolactone. Spironolactone is a diuretic that inhibits the hormone aldosterone. This inhibition reduces the activity of the H+ ATPase in the collecting duct, causing an accumulation of H+ that can precipitate metabolic acidosis. Notice the water slide on the right is spiral shaped. This is to remind you of spironolactone. All right, whew, that was a lot. Let's summarize this scene. As this scene covers causes of non-elevated anion gap metabolic acidosis, the park is located at sea level. This type of acidosis is sometimes referred to as hyperchloremic metabolic acidosis, so the park owner is named Cal for chloride. The license plates on the cars are also from California. Uteroenterostomies can cause non-elevated anion gap metabolic acidosis, so this water slide looks like a uterosigmoidostomy. Saline may cause acidosis, represented by the C. Endocrine disorders, particularly adrenal insufficiency, may lead to acidosis, so the adrenal glands atop the kidneys are damaged and falling over. Diarrhea is the number one cause of non-GAP metabolic acidosis, so the poopy diarrhea water pool is front and center in the scene. Carbonic anhydrase inhibitors induce acidosis by promoting loss of bicarb in the urine. Acetazolamide is used to treat glaucoma, so the headlights of the cars are eyeballs. Ammonium chloride is an acid, raising blood H+ concentration, and so we have an AC machine in the corner. R stands for renal tubular acidosis, and we have an inner tube in the pool to depict this. Lastly, spironolactone inhibits aldosterone, causing H+ accumulation, so one of the water slides is spiral-shaped. Hopefully you learned a thing or two, and maybe this story inspired you to buy a junkyard or become a used car salesman. You could be the next Cal.